Here's yet another article in the New York Times about, and here's the title. It says it all. Heart stents are useless for most stable patients, yet they're still widely used. Why are so many people agreeing to an expensive procedure and putting themselves at risk for a placebo effect? I've reported on this before, and so has the New York Times. This article was covering a couple of the academic articles that came out recently demonstrating that stents don't prevent heart attack. This is the New England Journal. This is the Courage trial, again, showing that stents don't prevent heart attack. This is the Lancet Journal article, ORBITA, and the ORBITA trial showed that they don't really cure angina either. So what do? They do work very well when they're used to unplug a blockage during a heart attack event. Only 10% of stents are placed for that reason. The rest of them are placed to prevent a heart attack. Again, the Courage trial shows that didn't work, or to help with angina. And the ORBITA trial shows that that really didn't work. Now, I've had feedback from patients saying, I had one and it worked. I'm not arguing that point. I'm just saying if you haven't had one and you're considering one, think twice. Now, what's the best way to prevent heart attack and stroke? It's that good old-fashioned lose weight, manage your diet, manage your exercise, manage your sleep. But it's not that simple. And that's why we've got over 500 videos to help you understand how to prevent your heart attack, stroke, and dementia. If you want to get deeper, we have courses. They're inexpensive, but they help you organize around a specific topic like cardiovascular inflammation. I look forward to meeting you and helping you prevent that heart attack, stroke, or dementia.
So I'm very excited to announce we now have a membership page. Now, what is that? That's the one place where you can go and access all of our digital products. It starts off with a few free things, like a lot of infographics, which help you understand the basics of insulin resistance, cardiovascular inflammation, and other key concepts on how to prevent heart attack and stroke. The next free item is the intro and first chapter of the book that we're writing on plaque. And the standards of medicine just aren't doing very well right now in terms of the number one killer and disabler, plaque. We don't do a good job of measuring it. We don't do a good job of monitoring it. And there are better ways. So that's what this book is all about. Again, go in and get a look at the intro and the first chapter. And if you've purchased the cardiovascular inflammation and IR courses, thank you so much for doing that. You purchased those at a time before we had them totally cleaned up, and we've cleaned them up now. And they're available for you right there on the membership page. Hit the link below, register, and go in and take a look. Look forward to seeing you there. Thank you.